folks are taking to the skies this holiday season, and this weekend, if you're flying one of these birds to go eat a bird, we've got some helpful tips for you to keep you sane and healthy, whether it be in the air, on the rails, or on the roads for Thanksgiving or the rest of this holiday season.
Well, I'm not sure if the phrase home for the holidays also actually includes Thanksgiving, but Thanksgiving's always about a month off from Christmas anyway, so why not? But folks aren't necessarily going home for turkey, either tomorrow or next month. Amanda Norcross from the website airfarewatchdog.com explains.
Within the U.S., travelers are heading to Orlando, they're heading to Las Vegas, Los Angeles, and then internationally, the top destination is Cancun, Mexico.
That sounds like fun. And if you didn't already know, today is generally considered the busiest travel day of the year, and this year, it's been busier than most.
According to a recent Airfare Watchdog survey, overall holiday travel is up by 9% this year since last year. Wednesday will actually be the busiest day ahead of Thanksgiving for travel, and more people will be taking to the skies this holiday season. 12% more people say they'll be flying for the holidays.
But if you're still on the fence about how you'll get to Grandma's house, you might be surprised by what else Amanda found in that survey.
Overall, for the roads, travel driving is actually down by 27% since last year, according to the Airfare Watchdog survey. So it seems more people are taking to the skies, finding relatively affordable airfares, wanting to go to places like Orlando because of the theme parks, and willing to pay the price.
Okay, so air travel, the bane of existence for some, has proven itself worthy of our travel dollars. But a 12% increase in flyers this holiday, at a time when load factor, which is the measure airlines use to gauge the percentage of seats filled on their flights, is at an all-time high, could mean some frustration in the fuselage. Amanda gives practical advice.
You definitely want to get to the airport as early as possible to ease the stress of that whole experience. Another big concern around this time of year is staying well. Nobody wants to get sick when they're heading home to see family and friends, or if you're taking a vacation this time of year, you certainly don't want to be sick.
And there's the rub. Nothing quite like being in a metal tube with 100 strangers for a few hours, to say nothing of the thousands of flyers who were in the plane before your flight. It's no surprise, then, that a recent study found lots of germs lurking on those seats and seatbelts. In fact, it looks like a lot of us are concerned about flying without picking up some of those in-flight extras that aren't listed in the back of that in-flight magazine.
67% of Americans say they're really concerned about getting sick with a cold or flu from other travelers this time of year.
Amanda again reminds us of the basics that are never too simple to say over and over.
What's best to do is use common sense when you're traveling. Cover your mouth when you cough or sneeze. Be sure you're washing your hands as much as possible. Be sure you're hydrating enough. Another great thing you can do is pack a little travel first aid kit.
Sickness is more than a state of being for the person who's ill. It can impact an entire holiday, and that's got folks nervous.
Thanksgiving dinner is also the number one holiday activity travelers say they'd get FOMO about if they were to get sick.
Don't worry, I didn't know what FOMO meant either. Apparently, it means anxiety about missing out on something good, like maybe your mom's favorite casserole, because you're laid up with an illness this holiday. Okay, so let's say you're ready to brave the germy plains for an end-of-the-year run to somewhere nice this holiday. Is there a certain day to get good deals?
You know, there's really no perfect day to book airfare. A really good airfare, though, can pop up at any time. What you can do, though, is sign up for airfare alerts with Airfare Watchdog, and you'll be alerted when a really good price comes up for a destination you're interested in traveling to.
And in case you're wondering, airfarewatchdog.com is a third-party site that gives you a free overview of what the major travel sites offer for fares and rates. Now, we're not endorsing the site, but its travel survey was certainly helpful for this report. Now, what is a good rate on airfare? Well, Amanda has some thoughts.
It really depends on your budget and the destination you're visiting. What's interesting is this time of year, international airfares are actually the better deal. We've seen flights from under $500 round trip to European destinations. So it might be worth considering a vacation versus a trip to see family and friends.
All right, let's get flying, driving, or training, folks. As Andy Williams sang, it's the holiday season. Now have a happy Thanksgiving. Brian Calfano, Ozarks First.